Hello students, this is Krupa Lakhani. Today we'll see chapter 3, log on to Access. What is an access? An access is a database which stores information in an organized way. It helps to manage and access large amount of information quickly and efficiently. We all use database in our daily life. For example, maintaining telephone diary, dictionary, maintaining a list of students and their addresses, a list of groceries, catalog in a library, list of customers in a bank, information in offices, etc. Microsoft Access is the most popular RDBMS software. RDBMS stands for Relational Database Management System. It stores data in the form of tables. Tables contains fields. All the columns in a table are called fields. A field describes a particular attribute of all the records in a table. For example, the field that mentions the roll number of a table student will store the roll number of all the students. Field contains data types, that is types of data in the field. Values are the data. Features of Microsoft Access. First, Access provides facility to break large information into small parts so that it is easy to access the information. Second, data redundancy, that is duplication of data, is reduced. Third, it increases the efficiency, speed and flexibility in searching and accessing information. Fourth, Access facilitates sharing of data. Different users can use same database to extract data according to their needs. Fifth, Access provides data security features and maintains integrity, which is useful to make your data more consistent and reliable. Sixth, Access provides the facility to create data forms so that user can enter the required information in the respective fields. It also reduces data entry errors. Queries helps you to get information on a specific topic from the information stored in the database. And last, reports allows you to present data in a meaningful and summarized manner. Here one example of employee table is shown to you. Employee is a table. Table are the building blocks of a database. They store the complete data in a structured manner, that is in the form of rows and columns. Every table has a finite number of rows and columns. Fields are the columns of a table. A field describes a particular attribute of all the records in a table. For example, last name, first name, phone number. Records are the rows. A record contains value for all the fields that belong to a single person or an entity. Microsoft Access allows you either to create a new database from scratch or create a database by using pre-installed templates. To open Microsoft Access, click on Start, All Programs, Microsoft Office, Microsoft Office Access 2010. When Access opens, you will find the backstage view on the screen. Click on the File tab and select the New option. Under the Available Template section, select the Blank Database option. You will get a blank database task pane on the right that prompts you to create a file. Select the file name in the File Name text box. If required, you can change the path from the Browse button placed adjacent to the file box. Click on the Create button. A new database will be created along with an empty table named Table 1. A new tab, that is Table Tools, will now be visible on the title bar. Creating a table using templates. One of the easiest way to create a table is to use a template. A template is a ready-to-use database that contains various types of tables, queries, forms, etc. needed to perform a specific task. Click on the Microsoft Access 2010 button. The backstage view appears on the screen. Now select the sample template category under the available templates. Access will display a list of all the available templates. Select any template from the displayed list. Closing Access application. After finishing the work in Access, click on the Close Database option in the File tab to close the current database. To close Microsoft Access application, click on the File, Exit option.
I hope you all enjoyed learning concepts of Microsoft Access. Thank you and have a nice day.